It was a happy blue sky kind of morning. I smiled as I rounded the corner of the house and heard my guineas stirring up quite a racket in the goat pen, goofy birds. It was one of those mornings that felt so good. Spring after a long winter always put life back into my body and soul. The air had the slight chill of night, but the sun was quickly warming up my corner of the earth. It felt so good. But my heart skipped a beat and panic rushed through my veins. I dropped my milk bucket and the clank echoed as it landed and rolled. I knew immediately I would have to act quickly when I saw Kira stuffed into the corner of our little goat shelter. She wasn't in her usual position, demanding to be fed. As my eyes took in the situation, they finally landed on the open door to the barn. I ran to the barn as fast as I could and yanked out all the goats with their heads in the bags of feed. Who left the door open? I was fuming. I was desperately looking for someone to blame. It could have been the kids, but it was probably me. I always double check the barn door when I leave. How could it be open? I was in a dither. Oh, you goats, you should know better. Don't you know any better? You should know when to stop, for goodness sake. My goat Kira, the leader of the herd, had ruminal acidosis and was bloated. Bloat in goats can also be called ruminal tympany. At the time, I didn't know much about goat bloat, but now I know that there are two main types of bloat: frothy bloat and choke bloat. Frothy bloat is caused by a buildup of gases in the rumen. This trapped air starts to put pressure on the heart and the lungs, and left untreated will end in death. These are some causes of frothy bloat in goats. So it can be caused by a number of different issues. One common one is goats getting into the barn where the grain is kept, even after you know you locked it up tight. If you like to know all the juicy details about a subject like I do, then this will fascinate you. When a goat chews food, their mouths produce something called bicarbonate. If your goats are eating hay or are in the pasture browsing all the lovely broadleaf plants that they adore and eating the pastured grass that's available to them, they are chewing a lot, which means there's a lot of bicarbonate being produced and consumed. This is a good thing. But if they are eating grain, especially grain that is highly ground up, or they have an affinity to wolfing down their grain without chewing it, they are producing very little or no bicarbonate. Or if they consume too much grain in one sitting, the bicarbonate can't keep up. This is where the problems begin. This is one reason it is a good idea to have fresh baking soda available for your goats at all times, especially in confined situations. The goats that you and I own are not in their natural environments, and they need our help providing them with things that will help keep them healthy. They self-medicate when their body says they need the baking soda, and it just helps them to regulate the delicate balance of their rumen. Bloat can also happen in the spring when the fresh, fast-growing green grass is tempting the goats after a long winter on dry hay. Switching a goat's diet too quickly can have drastic consequences. During the spring, it is also so important to transition to pasture slowly. This will prevent bloat if your goats consume too much lush grass when their rumen can't handle it. You can read more about that transitioning over to goats to pasture in the article that I'll link below, or actually I have a video on my channel that will tell you about that as well. So to sum up, frothy bloat, it can be caused by these things. They can be consuming too much grain, or they can be consuming too much grass when their rumen isn't ready for it. Now there's another one, choke bloat, which is also called free gas bloat. Choke bloat is caused by something like an obstruction being caught in the throat of the goat, which causes the goat to just choke and get all caught up. There are a number of ways a goat can get choked up. It could be something like a carrot piece or an apple or even grain. So here are some other causes of bloat. So if your goat is sick and you don't think that it was anything mentioned so far, then you may also consider some of these options or causes as well. So kids that are fed milk replacers as opposed to real goat's milk are at risk for bloat. Uncured, wet, and moldy hay consumed in excess will cause problems. Some weeds, especially milkweed, will imbalance that rumen. And sudden changes in the diet, like giving too much new food too fast or overeating on foods that produce lots of gas over a short period of time, or just overeating in general, will cause problems. Paralysis of the face, like with tetanus, can cause this too. So let's talk about the difference between a hay belly and bloat. So if your goat has a hay belly, they won't act sick and they won't display the symptoms of bloat, as I'll be talking about in a bit. When you push on the left side of a goat where their rumen is located, their hay belly, it will be squishy and may make an indent in the rumen if you were to push on it. The indent may even stay in place after you remove your hand. But with bloat, the goat will have a tight belly filled with trapped air. A tympani is a drum played in an orchestra. Your goat's belly will be tight as a drum, thus bloat being referred to as ruminal tympani. So here are some signs of goat bloat. When you walk into your goat pen, you may or may not be able to immediately see if your goat is bloated. Your goat may be found in the corner of the barn and away from the other goats. And only when you stand them up do you actually recognize their air-filled rumen. Now, when Kira was sick after her grain binge, I found her alone, standing up in the corner of our little goat pallet shelter, and I knew immediately that something was wrong just by looking at her. She was alone. She had the drooping ears and the sad eyes, and when I got up closer to her, her lips were actually pursed together in pain, and her belly was full and filled with air. You may also notice these signs of bloat as well. There may be restlessness. Kira was shifting back and forth on her feet. They may have noticeable abdominal discomfort. They have a loss of appetite or increased salivation. They may have a distended left side. They may be biting or even kicking at their abdomen. There may be some respiratory distress, collapse, and even death. So the treatment. I am so thankful I was able to get to Kira as quickly as I did. Timing does matter, and it's important to act as quickly as possible to treat your sick goat. So as laid out in my goat binder, you want to assess the symptoms and the surrounding and all of your surroundings first. Go through the symptom checker, take your goat's temperature, and then begin the treatment. So my goat binder has this full treatment plan laid out for goat bloat for you to follow. Now, option one in treatment, you may notice that it is advised to get a stomach tube down your goat's throat and administer mineral oil. Without experience doing this, it can be very tricky and nerve-wracking to know if you are in the right location to give the mineral oil. If the stomach tube ended up in the lungs, your goat will die a very painful death due to the oil ending up in their lungs and not in their stomach. But without the stomach tube, giving mineral oil to goats is dangerous. Mineral oil doesn't have any taste, so goats can't tell when to swallow and can easily aspirate it inside their throat, inside their lungs. So give your goats vegetable or peanut oil instead. If you do not have experience with the stomach tube, do not attempt this or call your vet for help and assistance. Now, if the goat can swallow and you are very careful to give small swallows at a time with a drenching gun, vegetable or peanut oil will help your goat out immensely.
Another option is to use a chokar to release the trapped gas. A chokar is a metal tube similar to a needle that punctures the rumen and releases the trapped gas through a tube. If it came down to it and you had a 14 or a 16 gauge needle, you could puncture the rumen with the needle to release the gas as well. But do this only is a last option, or involve your vet if possible. There are risks involved, but if it were a last ditch effort, then if that's all you could do at that point, it would be worth trying. Okay, another option is one that you can use if your goat is well enough to swallow. So with great care given, slowly give the goat small squirts of vegetable or peanut oil so that they can swallow it. If the goat were to aspirate this into their lungs, they are at risk of getting pneumonia from that foreign substance being in their lungs. So you will administer orally a fourth to a third cup of vegetable or peanut oil. Remember, mineral oil is tasteless and the goats can't tell when they need to swallow. It is advised not to use mineral oil. And no matter what anyone says, do not use Tide as a treatment plan in any way, shape, or form. The Tide today is not the Tide of the 1970s and is a poison. Do not give it to your goats ever. So after you've treated your goats, there are some next steps that you need to do. It doesn't end with just giving them some oil. So when your goat is bloated, they stop eating and drinking. They feel sick. If they aren't drinking, they are getting dehydrated. And dehydration can bring on a whole new set of problems. So it is really important to rehydrate your goat. Use a very large syringe or a drenching gun and drench electrolytes carefully down their throat. It's easier if you have two people for this if possible. So one person would stand over the goat and hold their chin with their mouth tilted up to the sky. And then the other person would carefully drench the electrolytes into their mouth. So position the tip of that syringe or the drench gun so that it is touching the inside of their cheek. This just helps them to be able to swallow without choking. A full treatment and prevention plan for goat bloat is available as a bonus in my goat binder. It has the complete list of ingredients for a special potion for poisoning that causes frothy bloat and vomiting. It is a must-have in your goat management, and it is included in the goat management binder. After you have given your goat the oil, intermittently walk them around and then massage their left side where the rumen is located. So you walk and massage. This will help break up the air bubbles. Do this until they start to burp and fart. Now to prevention. Oh, prevention, how we love thee. Prevention is incredibly important. None of us want to go out to the goat pen and find a wreck. So what can you do to prevent your goats from getting bloated? Here are a few goat bloat prevention steps. Gradually introduce your goats to pasture in the springtime. You'll want to give them some hay before letting them out into the pasture so that they have a full tummy and don't gorge on the green grass. You'll want to avoid feeding grains and concentrates that are finely ground. And you'll also preferably want to feed hay before giving your goats grains or concentrates as well. If you have an aggressive goat that doesn't chew grain and just swallows it, maybe try spreading it out over a larger area to reduce the risk of grain choke. Keep all of your grains in bins that are in a place that you can lock them up and close it all tightly. Keep all the doors locked that lead to grain bins, and then check and double check and triple check that it's actually locked. Don't feed goats shelled corn. It may be cheap and it's candy to goats, and it's actually not good for them. Not only nutritionally, but they will overload their systems with it any chance they can get. Make changes to your goats' diets carefully and slowly. They have sensitive rumens. And when you're bringing new goats home, ask what they were being fed. If the goat is being fed some grain, if you can, ask for a small bag of feed from the seller so that you can slowly make that transition during the next week over to the grain that you will end up using. Or if you don't have a grain picked out and you can purchase that same kind of grain, do that. So, I had a good ending. Will your ending be the same? Kira made a full recovery, thankfully. She still looks for any opportunity she can to get into the grain. Silly goat. I guess she didn't learn her lesson after all, but I did. And I'm so thankful I have a treatment and prevention plan printed out and laminated in my goat binder. Be sure to get yours mailed right to you so you can be prepared for anything and record everything. Get this goat management binder to make record keeping easy. So after you've done these first steps and you've administered oil to your goats, here are some things. Kira, you were the star of the show.